Because in the EU, food quality and safety is in general at a high level, and food testing is pretty well organized. But despite these efforts, food scandals and food fraud still occur, and consumers are not always protected from food contaminants and allergens. So for a moment, just imagine that simplified food testing would be available everywhere. In the field, at the farm and industry, at border inspection points, in supermarkets, even at your home. And imagine that food testing would be so easy and affordable that everybody could do it, ready for citizen science food control. A new generation of 11 PhD students are very eager to make this happen in the European Marie Curie Training Network Food Smartphone. And Food Smartphone is all about smartphone analyzers for on-site testing of food quality and safety parameters, and ultimately aims to transform the tools currently only used by food technicians into simplified formats suitable for any user. Handheld infrared scanners are already on the market and small enough to be integrated in smartphones soon. But food contaminants cannot be measured and require a different approach. The food smartphone approach, in which bio-inspired receptors will catch the food contaminants and your smartphone takes a snapshot and processes the data. But okay, lab tests take minutes, hours or even days, while smartphone users make selfies in seconds and they are not lab technicians at all, but ordinary people. So it's fair to say that food smartphone first requires a great deal of research in multiple areas, such as biorecognition, 3D printed microfluidics, image data handling, simplification of protocols, user interfaces, new apps, and so on and so on. Smartphones are prime communication tools, and the project aims to get non-expert users involved as well. You can follow the stories of our researchers in their weekly Food Smartphone blog. So find us on the internet, on Facebook and Twitter, and join the Food Smartphone community today.